Hello and welcome back to Scale Me Down and to part two of the build and review of this VQ Models de Havilland Twin Otter. We've got a lovely day today and they're thin on the ground at this time of the year, so we've decided to conduct a maiden flight, and if all goes well we'll go back to the workshop and fit the cowlings and other scale features. Don't forget to like and subscribe to support the channel. So without further ado, let's make a start with the maiden flight. The speed controller shut down into low voltage protection. And this was the culprit. Despite it showing it 95% charged on my tester, it just developed no power. Only one thing for it then. Thankfully, I got the nose down and put it down as level as I could, so there wasn't too much damage. And after some simple repairs, it was time to go back and try again. That's much better. I also tweaked the low voltage cutoff on the Hobbywing speed controllers while I had access to the short programming leads. The trims and centre of gravity seemed pretty close, and the handling was quite confidence inspiring, so I tried some low passes for the camera. So next up was to test the flap to elevator compensation and the stall in all three flap settings. This was all very benign and trainer-like, and in fact this would make a great second model. With this 6000mAh 4S battery pack, you should get more than 10 minutes of flight time. Let's also check out the reverse function on the speed controllers. Well, it works, but I think this function will be more useful when we build the floats.
That's better. Let's get it back to the workshop and get all its cowlings on and scale details.
We'll start by drilling out the lower cowlings with this step drill for the struts. I used a smear of Yoohoo Pore adhesive to assist the small self-tappers that hold the cowlings in place. An elastic band helps to hold everything still here while we drill out for the self-tapping screws, and a drop of CA glue helps firm up the wood. Now we can turn over the wings and repeat for the upper cowlings. These cowlings are vacuum forms and they're a bit brittle, but they fit well. Before I fitted the front cowlings, I used this Molitor chrome pen on the exhaust pipes. I think it looks really good. I used the spinner back plates to centre and position the cowlings accurately. Next, a light inside the fuselage marks the holes for the struts. I secured the captive nuts with a dab of CA and drew them into the wood by tightening the bolts. Then we can turn her over and drill for the self-tappers at the top of the struts. A bit of blue tack on the end of the screwdriver here really helps. I made these little blocks from some scrap foam and elastic bands to protect the struts during transport. I trimmed and glued this tail fairing into place using Yoohoo Pore. Thank you, VQ Models, for supplying these swatches of covering material. And the self-adhesive stickers are printed on a clear backing. Two blade spinners were supplied with the kit, and three blade counter-rotating spinners of the correct size can be difficult to obtain. So here I'm drawing some to make on our 3D printer. This was fairly simple, as I used the cone I'd drawn for our recent Pilates project. It's then a case of subtracting simple shapes and hollowing out the result. Once printed, we can prime, sand and paint them before fitting them to the aeroplane. The flight battery fits right up here and the cockpit seats clip out. And as the doors open, it'd be nice to fit some cockpit detail. So I printed this pilot on our Anycubic Photon resin printer to go with the other scale accessories included with the kit. I made his lower legs fit with rare earth magnets, so they just snap into place and can be bent out the way so you can slide him out of place to replace the flight battery. And here we are, all finished with the scale details added. I think she looks much better. Time to pop back to the field and get some shots of her in flight all finished. Very nice.
In conclusion then, what a lovely aeroplane from VQ Models. It's not without its faults, and I'm not always a big fan of this extra thick self-adhesive pre-printed covering, but it is very pretty. I'm also not always a fan of light ply construction in the egg crate style, i.e. tab and slot that's then wicked in with thin CA afterwards. But nevertheless, this model has great potential and will be a great second model or a follow-on from a standard club trainer that's semi-scale and a bit more interesting. Join us in the next episode where we'll build some floats and we'll put her up on floats for water operations. I can't wait to see that. Thanks for watching and don't forget to like and subscribe to support the channel. We'll see you next time.